Thank you. Welcome. Welcome to If I Ruled the World, the programme where perfectly natural human beings are transformed by modern science into politicians. And our genetically modified vegetables tonight are Graeme Garden and John Thomson on the blue team, and on the red team, Jeremy Hardy and Linda Smith. We start with a round called State of the Nation, and in this what we've done is we've asked our audience here a number of questions, and to test how much the politicians are in touch with members of the public, they have to guess or work out what the most popular answers would be. Let's start with you, Jeremy, this week. Now, the audience has asked this question: what is Paddy Ashdown's lasting contribution to British politics?
Well, I think Paddy brought a great deal of militaristic virility to the Liberals. They made great play of his army background, and there was a great sense of, we might look nerdy, but our leader knows how to kill a man with his bare hands.
Yes. His spare hands or his bare hands?
His bare hands.
Bare hands, yes. Spare hands would be ridiculous.
Bare hands are permanently occupied.
Yeah. But apart from that, Paddy will be remembered for the ability to hide his eyes inside his face at all times.
Very much so.
Is that what you think his lasting contribution is?
I would say he turned the Liberals into a party not dominated by people wearing sandals.
Right. So the elimination of sandals from Liberal Party will be his contribution.
And the creation of the two-party state, I think.
Yes, all right. It's really one answer we're aiming for rather than every answer you could possibly think of.
Questions, questions, questions,
yes.
And let's see what the people have to say.
Well, let's see what their answer. What is Paddy Ashdown's lasting contribution to British politics? The answer is wearing jumpers. So nothing there for you, I don't think, Jeremy. Let's go on to Graeme. Question here for the audience was, what does the Queen spend her money on? What do you think the audience answered to that?
I guess what the audience thought was, well, she's a pensioner now, so it's probably pet food and scratch cards.
Yes. Well, for the lottery?
Yes.
What would she do if she won the lottery? It wouldn't change her lifestyle, would it?
She'd have a big cheque.
Yes.
That's true, as opposed to a big Greek.
Yes. Yes.
So, failing that, I suppose she would probably spend her money on hats, handbags or horses. And I think the audience would have gone for horses.
Horses. So you think the most popular answer is horses. What did the Queen spend her money on? What was the answer? Dog food. Corgi meter, you mentioned it, you almost went for it.
Yes,
but
yes.
Scratch cards was also mentioned. Some wag suggested hips for her mum. I'm sure her mum is National Health, so I don't think that can be right. Linda, who should be the government's official male role model?
It's Mohammed Al-Fayed, because because he's generously and patriotically, he's very patriotic, not to his own country, obviously. patriotically given us our New England football manager, Dodie Keegan.
So you're going for Mohammed Al-Fayed.
That would be my personal choice, but looking at the audience, I would suggest probably it'll be something like George Clooney.
So who is the government's official male role model? Des Lynam. Again, you got so close going towards football. Mohammed Al-Fayed wasn't mentioned. Graeme Garden got 8 votes, and Jeremy Hardy got 5, and I got 1. One person answered, an interesting answer, definitely not Richard Branson. I work for him and he's a knob. John, who should be the government's official female role model?
Looking at the audience, normally an audience is of an older generation, so I would have said Thora Hurd.
Yeah.
But it's a younger crowd. Possibly All Saints. I thought maybe Barbara Windsor.
Yeah.
Because she's a member of the royal family.
Yeah. Keep going with the answer then.
I'll say All Saints.
Oh, you're here for All Saints?
Saints, yes.
OK, audience answered Mo Molem, 21%. This is a genuine answer. A more sensible audience than perhaps you were thinking. They definitely went for Mo Molem, 21%, just beating Denise Van Outen at 19%. And somebody suggested an interesting suggestion. I thought you were going to get to eventually a nun in a tight vest. You always get one of those. Anyway, well done, the audience. Not so well done, the panel. Right, so let's go on to the yes-no round now. It's very important for any politician to be able to avoid answering a question, and certainly you must never use the word yes or no in this round. If you use yes or no, we'll hear this noise. and you'll be eliminated from the round. Jeremy, Jack Straw, do you agree with his views on crime?
Jack Straw, let us not forget, invented the idea of a national bedtime for all children. Admittedly, he was overtired
and
showing
that?
Off. He did.
When?
It was one of his. A couple of years ago, before we were in government, he was being a bit weird and trippy. And,
was that when he was a student leader?
No, listen.
Would you confront a mugger, Linda? Are you happy to talk about this question?
That depends what you mean by a mugger.
Well, so, really. Well, somebody robs you in the street.
Oh, I thought you meant perhaps somebody like, I don't know, Shane Ritchie or something.
No. Would you confront a mugger?
I think I may have a go, as I believe the expression
yes.
is.
Do you think we are living in a walk-on-by society?
I think it's more of a do-you-know-the-way-to-San-Jose sort of society.
Are you a fan of Dionne Warwick?
I have a few of her discs.
Really?
I'm a plastic surgeon in my spare time.
Are you? Could you sort me out? Would you attack me if I had a gun?
Only if you wanted me to.
Are you tough on crime?
I think I'm tough on the causes of crime.
Is there a difference?
A subtle one.
Let's just go over to Graeme Garden. I haven't spoken to you for a while, have I?
You haven't.
Genetically modified foods. Have you a view on that?
I do have a view, yeah.
Do you think it's dangerous? You slipped that straight past me. Duty-free, John Thomson. Do you buy duty-frees?
Without exception.
Do you think it's right it should be abolished within Europe?
Abolished in Europe? I think not, sir.
Do you think it's going to cost thousands of jobs?
Jobs will be created, I would have thought.
Created? How is that?
Less chance of alcoholics becoming...
But is duty-free ever that much cheaper anyway?
I've found on occasion it is.
Do you travel abroad?
Yeah.
I think that was a year, wasn't it? No?
Just clear my throat.
Did you say yes?
I was a 16, I'm a
17. You say yes?
I did not.
Are you sure?
Absolutely.
Kevin Keegan, are you pleased to have been appointed England manager?
I have no interest in football whatsoever.
So, are you a man... No interest, absolutely. There's no interest, yes.
Oh!
No interest, well done. So, I declare Linda Smith the winner there. Controversial offside decision there as we go on to the pager round. In this round, I'll be interviewing Graeme and Jeremy on a matter of importance, but their performance is being monitored by party spin doctors who'll be sending advice to them on their pagers. You'll be able to follow what the advice is by looking at the screen. So let's start first of all with you, Graeme. What I want to talk to you about is proportional representation.
Mm.
Now, do you think that this is a method that's going to eventually replace the first-past-the-post system for the Westminster elections?
I think it certainly will replace FPTP, as we call it.
Yes.
And particularly with regard to the STV, the sexually transmitted vote.
Yes.
I think we'll find that the people will feel that the PR system will...
But there are a lot of complicated... There's quite a lot of different ways... There are different ways of doing this, aren't there? There's the single transferable vote system. Is this a serious topic or not to you? I mean,
it's a very, very serious topic indeed. And
why
no,
should
shut
it take...
up!
Well, Mr. Garden, I'm asking you what sort of system you're advocating and when
global
is it going to be brought in? I'm not sure this is particularly relevant to the issue at hand, because we are using a sort of form of proportional representation in European elections, in the Scottish elections.
Yes,
and
but
in
it's
some
only
of
a
the...
form, it's not the real thing.
Exactly.
It doesn't give people the chance to do, if every single person in the country, one, two, three, four, five, six,
millions of people. Do people understand how it's going to work? I mean, at the moment, just putting an X on a box is one thing.
I think people don't.
Yeah.
I think people don't understand how it works yet.
Yes.
I mean, they're behaving like Germans, to be honest.
Well, Germans understand proportional representation. They've had it for years.
They have it, but they don't understand it.
I think they do. They elect all various states within Germany under
this
system.
That's right, but look who they vote for.
They vote for Germans, obviously.
Well, that's their big mistake, isn't it? You know, we don't want the people of this country to vote for Germans.
Oh. So are you only in favour of this system because you think that it's the only way you're ever going to get back into power?
I think the only way I'm going to get back into power is to reveal that I'm a woman.
Thank you very much, Graeme Robb. Certainly worked for Margaret Thatcher. As we go on...